Let me guess, you have breadcrumbs enabled in Visual Studio Code, but you're not really using them. And you're not using them because you don't know how useful they really are. We will change this in the next few minutes. Breadcrumbs are enabled by default, and you can see them on top of your currently opened editor, right here. At a glance, I can see exactly where in the document structure is my currently opened file. Main CSS is in the folder CSS, and currently I'm focused on the selector stickers list. But the breadcrumbs also allow you to navigate between different files, folders, and even symbols within certain files. You can click on any part of breadcrumbs and you will see all files and folders that are at the same level in the document structure. Here I can see all files and folders that are at the level of my CSS folder. And if I click on main CSS, I will see all files that are in the CSS directory. Likewise, if I click on a symbol, I will see all symbols that are available in this particular file. As I have a CSS file open now, I see CSS symbols or classes in this case, but for any other language, you will see symbols for that particular language. As you can see, this is pretty handy, but there's more to it. You can use only your keyboard to navigate breadcrumbs. When you're working in the editor, if you hit Command Shift Dot shortcut, this will open the latest element in the breadcrumbs structure and allow you to easily navigate them. You can use your arrow keys to go up and down in this dropdown, or left and right to move across the document structure. When the dropdown is opened, you can start typing to find something. So for example, if I type N, I will find my normalized file. If I type M, I will jump back to my main CSS, and so on. You can also focus breadcrumbs using your keyboard navigation without actually opening the dropdown menu. You can use Command Shift Semicolon shortcut, and this will work exactly as you expect. The focus will shift to breadcrumbs and you can then use your arrow keys to navigate around those breadcrumbs. If you want to return focus to your editor, you have to hit the space key, which will return you exactly to the item in breadcrumbs that was focused. And if you still want to open a dropdown, you can use the enter key or simply up or down arrows, which will immediately allow you to navigate between files, folders, or symbols. You can of course adjust breadcrumbs to your liking. I'm going to open settings now and I will go into workbench breadcrumbs. Here you'll see a number of useful options. You can entirely enable or disable breadcrumbs. You can change how file paths are shown. You can turn off icons if you want. And then there's a number of options for different languages. Do you want to show classes, constants, and so on and so on. You can tweak this to your liking and make breadcrumbs really useful for exactly your use case, for exactly what you need. Last options are symbol path and the symbol sort order, which allows you to sort symbols in breadcrumbs according to position in the file, to the name, or type. Position is the default value, but I kind of like the name here, so this is what I'm using. And this is pretty much everything you need to know about the breadcrumbs. They don't only allow you to see where in the file path you currently are, but they actually allow you to very easily navigate between symbols, files, and even folders. Before I sign off, the question for you is, are you using breadcrumbs or will you start using them a bit more after watching this? Let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in a different Visual Studio Code symbol. Or rather, in the next video.